that now has me kind of captured in there. I want to be a little bit further away from the center point, so I'm actually going to run this. I'm going to pull it out this way, and that will get me get that tine over there a little bit more. And as you get closer to finish, you're going to be kind of opening up the tines with your fingers. Sometimes you can use a tool, but generally you don't have the kind of room that you started out with. It's like painting yourself into the corner of a room. Almost forgot what I was trying to do. So I take my flat pliers again, I get in between here, and I put leverage pressure on the outside. Okay, so now we have it sitting about where we want. It's curled up. Now we're gonna, actually that's right where we want it, right there. I want to bend this out just a little bit more. If you're working with the stone on the piece, make sure you're really careful, because some of these stones are just really, really fragile. Once you get into the opals and the crystals, I do like that. You have to take into account the position of the piece. So where it's laying like this, you want this piece here to be shiny so it catches any light, and while it's on the person. So right now we need to put a bend right here. That bend to fold this way and tuck around. So I'm going to use these because they give me a nice turning radius and they give me good leverage to be able to twist as I'm doing it. So twisted. Now we have to run things going backwards now. We need to drop this right here and let it come back. Kind of round it out a little bit to give ourselves some room. Again, let it come up. Bring that around. Grab this whole thing now and lift it up. Okay, so now we're captured. So this piece here can go down a little bit, which is going to make us touch right here, which is good because that'll make it nice and snug. We'll be captured up front by this little node here. Now, realistically, once we get that snug, it really shouldn't go anywhere. And we could do something like use this tine, come out, and then do a drop. So we could hold a stone or a bead or something and not actually have to come all the way around to capture it. Yeah, because that keeps this from going up. So, let's call that part done. Now what we have to do is we have to clean up all of this stuff. So see all of our scratches here? We've got to clean all of that up. So this is a quick change release. These are 3/32 shaft bits, and I think right now this is a 120 bit. I'm going to go to my 180 drum bit. Let me get off all of our tool marks. They're not all going to come out, but we want to get it nice and clean. Also, no sharp anything. There should be no sharp edges. I'm trying to fade in the old stuff into the new stuff that's been exposed. Pick up any point. Okay. Now I'm going to switch over to a grit infused bit. These spin and we'll get in the small areas I couldn't get before. kind of blend everything in together. Just saw something that doesn't quite look right.